Hey folks, I'm Kyle Schoenhear, B&M Pro Staffer and owner of All Seasons Guide Service in Southern Illinois. I guide full-time year-round and target some real good crappie in the winter months, which brings me to the technique I'd like to show you guys, and that's bottom bouncing deep structure in wintertime. It's a great way to target some real good fish. You're going to want to look for this pattern to start. Generally, when the water temps fall to the mid to upper 40s, anywhere in there is a good time to start trying this technique. The areas you're going to want to try, you're going to want to try deep ledges on the main river channel, your secondary creek channel ledges, and even your deep flats off of your main river channel. But the most important thing about this, you're going to want to use your electronics to find structure in these areas. You can catch a few fish just on the ledges alone, but you're really going to get some good numbers finding this structure. And once you've found these areas, the structure in these areas, this technique, once you're comfortable with it, is going to allow you to pinpoint some deep crappie all through the winter months. Folks, now I'd like to show you just a little bit about the equipment we're using. Your most important part of this whole setup is going to be your B&M Bucks graphite jig pole. For this technique, I'm using a 12-foot rod. This is probably my favorite pole B&M makes, and the fact is it's B&M's workhorse pole. This was the first graphite crappie pole introduced. B&M makes a great pole for almost every technique out there, but if you're looking for one rod, you know, that will help you in every technique, this is your rod. Now I'd like to talk to you just a little bit about how the rest of this is set up. I'm coming off my B&M West Point spinning reel with 15-pound braid. This is its 15-pound but 4-pound diameter, so it's real thin. Strong line when you're fishing at depths of 30 foot plus. One real advantage to the braid is when you're that deep, any bite you feel that reaches this swivel, you're going to feel it in an instant. So coming off my braid, I'm coming to a number 8 barrel swivel, and then I'm coming down with 14-pound monofilament. The reason for that is you're going to be fishing, like I said, heavy cover. You don't want to be wasting time retying, so you want to go ahead and use a good weight line. Coming down next is one of the most important things about this drop. I'm going to tie 4 overhand knots, and what that's going to do, that's going to stand that hook out off your main line. Off of that loop, I've got a True Turn number 2 blood red hook. This is a great setup here. It's a cam action, and when a fish bites this, the idea behind this is it's supposed to turn towards the pressure, so you're going to hook up with some more fish. Down below that is just a simple 1/2 ounce bank sinker, and there's your setup. Hey folks, I just want to go in a little more detail about how I tie this. Remember, I'm coming off my 15-pound braid with a number 8 barrel swivel. Okay, then I'm coming down with 14-pound mono. What I'm going to do, I'm going to come about 8 inches. Okay, then I'm going to make a loop probably about 3 inches. I'm going to just basically start doing overhand knots. And where you want to start, you're going to want to start about an inch from the end of your loop. Okay, this is going to give you enough room to get your hook on there afterwards. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to keep going 4 knots pretty close together. And the reason it's 4, you don't want to get it too long because it's going to defeat the purpose of these knots. These knots are on here to keep this off your main line. Keep that minnow out, standing out off your main line. Okay, we got our 4 knots there. Okay, what I'm going to do, I'm going to come down about 10 inches below that. Okay, I'm going to make another loop. The trick to tying this weight on, you know, versus a regular Palomar or any other knot, you want to really tie your knot like this because you're going to be pulling this weight up through heavy cover and stuff like that. So you're going to pinch this loop together. You're going to run your loop through. You're just basically going to start an overhand knot. Okay, and you're going to run this loop around your weight and back tight. Okay, that'll hold that weight on there tight, even while you're ripping that through heavy cover. Okay, we've got that on. Now we're going to come back to our loop. You're going to pinch that tight. You're gonna run that through the eye. Pull it through. And there's our bottom bouncer set up. Again, folks, I hope this helped you. Just want to talk to you a little bit about wintertime fishing. Just remember that, you know, crappie aren't like birds where they fly south for the winter. They're there. And hopefully this technique will help you target crappie in the wintertime.